Oh, an umbrella! Which means...
I nearly just jumped to the ground.
Which means without glasses.
Right, okay.
But, you know, everything in German sounds far more severe.
He could have been saying, would you like some tea?
Yeah.
And you still jump for cover.
He really wouldn't have.
Yeah. He's an actor from plain sight! I'm Oliver Trevena here at the Young Hollywood Studio with Fred Weller. How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks for stopping in.
Thank you for having me,
Oliver. Busy schedule.
Yeah, fairly busy, wrapping up in plain sight, fifth and final.
Wow, then you're even busier, so thanks for stopping in.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
I'll give you a hug, it's so much of a thing.
Let's do it, come on.
Manly hug.
Yeah, you see that?
You did mention
that. Not afraid of that.
Yeah,
too many people are afraid of that.
Yeah, we're fine with it. Right. Wow, that was good in a way, and it felt weird.
You don't feel like we have to talk about sports now or anything?
No. No,
none of the usual homophobic crud. None of that.
Beer!
Let's move on. Okay.
Let's have some beer now. Slam the Fiji.
We're men!
Yes, men, Vikings, warriors, meat.
If you'd let me and Ab babysit once in a while.
Yeah, leave Nora with you too.
Couldn't be in better hands. Ab's a detective who effectively raised three younger siblings. And I'm a marshal from a family.
Marshall?
Final season. It's heartbreaking.
Yes, the culmination of 5 years of romantic frustration and you know, busting bad guys.
Right. How does that feel when something that long ends? Well, I know how it feels when a relationship ends that long, but...
It's like that.
Yeah, it feels like
that. It's like that. No, like, I don't know why people keep asking me, is it bittersweet? I guess when I have my next job, it'll be bittersweet. Now it's just bitter.
Right, okay.
It's pretty much just, it's sad because I really love the job and I love working with Mary McCormick and we goof around a lot and we waste a lot of time cracking up.
Hey, cheekbones, you good?
Yeah, just these pantyhose chafe.
You were just telling me quite an interesting story about you and the airports. You play this game where you...
Well, it's a proclivity of mine. I like to be frisked. I enjoy the process of being frisked. It has to do with loneliness. I've been married for a while. Maybe there's not as much touch as there used to be. And so I find that if you go to the airport and you just kind of do this a lot, you know, you're gonna wind up having some human contact.
You did tell me about your moment in Berlin, which is a great...
We were going to Berlin through East Germany, and I was with my younger brother, and I was just trying to freak him out, and I had some sunglasses on, and so as we went through the customs, and I gave the East German official my passport, I started doing this. And my brother kind of went, stop it like that. Ouch. And it really, I'm sorry about that.
Wow.
Sorry, was that, I know. You know what? It surprises a lot of people, but I actually, I take very little steroids, actually. This is mostly
natural. You got to cover them guns up.
In any case, the East German guy didn't like it.
Right.
He took it amiss, and he yelled at me in German what he said.
Which sounds a lot worse than yelling at any other language.
He went, oh, an umbrella! Which means...
I nearly just jumped to the ground.
Which means without glasses.
Right, okay.
But, you know, everything in German sounds far more severe.
He could have been saying, would you like some tea?
Yeah.
And you still jump for cover.
He really wouldn't have.
Yeah.
It still would have been scary.
He's an actor from plain sight!
You're doing the right thing, Eddie. And who knows, maybe a step toward a country you once loved enough to die for is the... Whoa! Eddie! Eddie!
You have worked a lot as an actor, like an extreme lot of working. You do a lot of theatre as well. What do you prefer, theatre or TV or film? Is there any preference?
I love doing plays. You know, we just moved from New York. We just moved out here in September. After we moved, we found out the show was ending.
Right.
So...
Always the way.
You know.
C'est la vie.
But we think we'll stay.
Right.
We like it here.
But it's also good to be here if you're now on the lookout for your new job. Not, well, that you're on the lookout, I'm sure you've got flowing ink.
Well, that's true. I would like to be out here where there's more TV and
but
film.
The theatre stuff is out here.
In the theatres, I'm going to just take a break from the theatre for a while.
What's the biggest difference, would you say? LA, New York.
Oh, I thought you meant theatre and television.
Well, that's
money.
Money.
Probably be the biggest,
guessed that, yeah.
Most substantial difference.
Right. But you get that in the immediate satisfaction at the end.
Yeah.
Did that sound like you were in theater again?
Yeah, that I thought for a second, oh, wow.
Close your eyes.
I kind of had a little bit of a flashback.
Woo!
Oh, no. Oh, no. Bravo! No, I don't do that.
You're back.
I don't yell my own bravos like that, unless it's...
Do you take a little bow at the end? One of them? That was a headbutt.
In the theater?
Yeah, afterwards. You always just...
Yeah, you take a bow. I mean, you have to take a bow.
Right, but how big do you go? Because I've noticed there's a big variation. It's that, or it can be...
The important thing is to try to seem modest while still manipulating the audience into applauding as long as possible. So it has to be a kind of a... this, but it still takes a little bit longer than necessary.
Right.
So that way you don't seem arrogant, but they still have to kind of keep going.
And you keep coming back. Do you do that? Where they go out the curtain and then you come back? To the point of your hands, I think I've got, you know, blisters on my hands from going to theater.
Yeah, you want to try to manipulate them into, but not longer than, here's what you want to avoid. You want to avoid, you're still on stage while they've stopped clapping. You don't want to be walking off, so once you finish bowing, you pretty much want to scurry a little bit, but in a, you know, as masculine a way as possible.
Great advice for actors out there doing theater.
Yeah, scurry. But
scurry.
But in a way that is not shameful.
Right. Fred, it's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you.
In Plain Sight, fifth season. You've got to watch it.